Hi, I am Nishant Burte. I am third year M.Tech student in CAC department in IIT Bombay. I am going to explain about the network file system today. So, you have to make a group of two. One laptop will be acting as server, one will be acting as client. So, what is network file system? With this system, users can access the files across the network. That means you can sit on one laptop and create some file and access that file on some other machine. So I will start with the server installation. So I hope you have fixed that who will be the server and who will be the client. So this step is to be followed by the person who is doing the server side. The packages required for NFS file system are NFS kernel, NFS kernel server, NFS common, and port map. Okay, so as you can see from your printouts, there will be three packages needed for the server installation. That is NFS kernel server, NFS common, and port map. So these steps will be done only by the person who is doing the server thing. So I have in one window one machine, that is OSL50. The other machine is OSL52. So OSL50 will be acting as server and OSL52 will be acting as client. I will run the first command, that is apt-get install, and the three package names. So it will install all the three packages. So I am running this command apt-get install NFS kernel server, NFS common, and port map. It will install these packages on server. This has to be run on server side only. Okay, next thing is we have to create a directory on this NFS file system. And then we can write some files which can be accessed on some other computer. So we will create a directory like /extra/dir. So I am creating directory in /extra directory as NFS. Okay, in your case, I think /extra is not there, so you can create a directory mkdir/home/nfs. So your command will be /home/nfs. So I have highlighted the command. You can look at the board and type this. You can give any name to this directory. For example, I am giving the name as NFS. Basically, we want to make this directory accessible from other client machines. Next thing, open this file /etc/exports using Vim editor. Write this command and open this file. You will see the commented lines. Come at the end, press I so that you will open it in write mode. And go to the last line. Okay, the file that you have to open is /etc/exports, s at the end. Okay, type sudo space su, press enter. It will ask for password. You enter the password as 123 because it is the administrative user's password. So after this sudo su, you will have the administrative privileges. If it is not there, create it. Yeah, open this file, press I to go to write mode. It will show you are in the insert mode at the end. You have to write the line which is there in the slide, your slides, /extra/nfs. In your case, /home/nfs, the IP address of the client system, and then these three attributes. Okay, in the exports file, what you have to write is you want to make this directory available to some client machine. So that is why you have to specify which is the IP address of the client to which you want to make it available. IP has to be replaced with the actual IP address. Bracket will be same. So you have to write /home/NFS space the client machine's IP address in bracket, same thing. So as you have two clients, you have to make two lines. Only difference will be the IP addresses of clients will be different because you are using two clients. Client's IP has to be given. You want to make this directory available to some client. So first parameter is the directory which you want to make available to clients. The IP address is the client IP address. You want to make file system as read write. The second parameter is if you have logged in using root permission and using NFS directory, then can you delete the file as per the server's root permission or not? So I have this web page which explains the use of no root squash parameter. So and on client system, if you have logged in using root, then can you delete the file? Can you delete the NFS file with server's root permission or not? Yes, on one line you have to make entry for first client, on second line you have to make entry for second client. No, you have to write every machine line by line. So you are not writing the second line, that is read only with read only permission. You have to make entry for this line only, not this line. Here you have to write /home/NFS because that is the directory you want to make available to clients. This is the IP address of client, and from this to this, the same thing will be written for both lines. So you have to make entries similar to this. On the second line, this is the IP of first client. On the second line, same thing will be written, home NFS IP2. So I hope you have made entries similar to this in your file. Write the file with escape shift colon WQ. Enter. After making these changes, you have to restart the NFS kernel server process with the next command in your slide, that is /etc/initd/NFS-kernel-server-restart. You open this file /etc/exports. You have to write line similar to this. In your case, it will be /home/NFS because you have made the directory in that /home. So instead of /extra, you will write /home, then space, then you have to write the IP address of the client machine which you will be using. To get the IP address of the client, you have to run ifconfig command on your client. So OSL52 is my client, so I am running ifconfig. You will see the IP address of client. This IP address you have to put in /etc/exports. So I want to make one point clear. These two entries are not to be entered. These are exclusive. So that is why I said only enter this thing. Only on the first line you have to make write the IP address of first client. On the second line, same thing is to be written with writing IP address of second client. This is not to be entered. So for the explanation purpose, I have also made the two entries in /etc/exports. The entries are similar except the IP address of clients are changed. One is 11.52 and second is 11.51. Both are acting as my clients. Okay, let's move to the next step now. After writing the entries in exports file, you have to run this command. Restarting NFS kernel server process. So you have to enter command at /etc/init.d/nfs-kernel-server restart. I have run the command here and you can see the output. Okay, next thing is after you have made the entries in exports file, it has to be made public using export fs -ra command. So you can run export fs -ra on the server. So I am running export fs -ra on server side. So do not consider these warnings, these are normal. So up till now I had done the server installation. First I installed 3 packages. I created NFS directory. I have written the directory name and IP address of client in export S file. I have restarted the NFS kernel server process and I have run export fs command, and this makes the server installation complete. Okay, the next step is we are moving now to client installation. Whoever is acting as clients should run the following commands now. So OSL52 is acting as my client. So I will run the client side commands on this machine, OSL52. So first you have to install 2 packages using apt-get install. The package names are NFS common and port map. So after running these commands, NFS packages are installed on my client machine. Okay, on the client side, I had to install the NFS packages. So you can refer to your slides also. In that, the command written is apt-get install NFS common and port map. So using this command, you can install the 2 packages. Okay, once again, I will repeat this command, and henceforth, you are doing the configuration on the client side, not the server side. Server side configuration is done. Now I have to make one directory on which through which I will access the NFS directory that is created on the server. So I will create a directory as /extra/nfs-client. So in your case, you have to run the command as mkdir /home/nfs-client. So now you have created the directory. Now you have to mount the directory which was created on server to this directory. So how to do that is the third command which is given in the slide. First you will need to know the IP address of the server from which you will be accessing the NFS directory. So now go to server, type ifconfig command. So OSL50 is my server. I will type ifconfig, enter. This will give me the IP address of the server. So note down this IP address of the server. So on the client side, you have to run the command as mount space IP address of the server 11.50 is my IP address of the server, so I am entering this value, colon, the directory on the server which you want to enable as NFS. So the directory name was /extra/nfs. In your case, the directory name will be /home/nfs. So I will explain these parameters of the third command again. You have to mount a directory from server to client, so that is why we are using mount command. Now we have to specify the IP address of the server from which you want to get the directory. So this is the IP address of server, NFS server. This is the directory on the server from which you want to get the NFS data, and this is the directory on the client on which you are mounting the server directory. So I will write the command that you will be writing on your client, mount space IP address of your server, then /home/NFS, this is the directory we created on the server, and then /home/NFS-client, this is the directory we created on the client. So these three commands will complete your client installation. I hope everyone is completed the client installation. So we can test what we have done. Go to your server. On your server, you have created directory at /home/NFS. Go to that directory using cd command. You will be running the command at cd /home/NFS. Once you go to this directory, you have to create a file in this directory using vim. Type vim space file name. I have given file name as abc. Press I to write in the file. I will write in the file as nfs con. Configuration successful. I will save the file using escape shift colon wq, enter. So I have let's see the file using ls command. So you will see this file in your /extra/NFS directory. Now go to client. Go to the directory which you have just created, that is /home/NFS client. For me it's /extra/NFS client, and you can if you do ls, you will see the same file which you had created on the server, that is displayed on the client also. If you open this file using vim space abc, you will see the same thing written on that file. You can edit this file from client side. Now I will edit the file. I will remove the words configuration successful. I will retain only NFS. I am doing this from the client side. Now I am saving the file with escape shift colon wq, enter. I have done this on NFS client, that is OSL 52. Now I will go to OSL 50, that is my server. I will see the file here using vim command, vim abc. Here I can see the changes reflected. Now the application is this. In our department, we have NFS server in which we have the home directories of all students, and all the machines in the labs are NFS clients. So whenever a student logs on any of the machine, he can see his own home directory from any machine through the NFS configuration. So you need not copy your data every time you go to some different machine. Every of your data will be there in your home directory, and it can be accessible through any of the client machine. Now the fourth slide is simple. What you had done in client installation, you had mounted the directory using mount command, but on every reboot you don't want to run this command again and again. So what you can do is, on the client side, in /etc/fs tab, you can write entries like this. IP will be the IP address of the server. This is the directory to be mounted from the server. This is the directory on the client. And we are specifying the file system type as NFS. This and this has to be written on the same single line. So these are not the two lines. This has to be written defaults, and all this has to be written after NFS, preferably using tabs in between. So with this configuration, on every reboot of your client machine, these directories will be automatically mounted, and you need not run the third mount command again and again. Okay, that is how we have completed the NFS client server installation and configuration process. Thank you.